Hey, that's me, and I'm at the Milano Auto Classica. I'm sure you're wondering what I'm about to see in this video, and I can assure you that you're going to see a lot of cool cars. Okay, I know it. If you know the Milano Auto Classica, I know you're wondering why this video came out 6 months after the exposition. The answer is pretty simple. I'm editing this video already 4 times, and every time was boring as shit. But I think this time I nail it, so sit comfortable and enjoy the video. What is the Milano Auto Classica?
Yeah, the Milano Auto Classica is an expo where people all around Italy, but not only, there is people from Europe come here and sell cars. And not only that.
Show your new or future projects. You can see some of the best racing prototypes, some of the newest cars, some of the old glories, and most of them are on sale. Probably 95% of us will not be able to buy these amazing vehicles, except if you make disappear your old rich uncle or you still have both kidneys. But also we, the 95%, we can buy stuff inside here. There are car parts of old cars that usually are pretty hard to find.
As you can see, you can find all parts here. Like if you need it, if you have a really old car where you can't find a part, this is the best place where you have to come, because surely somewhere around here you will find it.
And a lot of gadgets, even some dog stuff that I really don't understand why they were here.
Dogs? What the f***?
But the best thing of the event is the possibility to touch and see so closely all this car that you will not see around. And thanks to the fact that I have a camera pointing at my face, I was able to meet some really interesting person. This place gives you also the possibility to see some really interesting and rare car. But you are going to see everything during the video.
This is my future daily car. Dodge Charger RT 69, I think. Maybe 70, this one. I don't like the two colors top that this one have, but looks simply beautiful. There is a Diablo right there. This Lamborghini Countach, it's probably one of the best car ever made. But simply about the aesthetic of the car, it's beautiful. Watch the rear wing. It looks like a table, like they arrive here and they stick a table on the car. The massive intake for the air right here on the side. Watch the doors.
Watch
how the air flow to cooling the engine, the huge engine that is right here. So it's beautiful. And how wide is the back compared to the front? It's insane. This is gorgeous. I absolutely want to try one of these one day. And I fall in love even more with this car, with the movie The Wolf of Wall Street. I don't know if you remember that scene, but if you didn't see the movie yet, there is a part with that car that is amazing. Probably one of the best scenes in the movie industry ever.
Jordan. Jordan? Oh, Jesus, where are you?
I'm in a country club.
What?
I'm in a country club.
We have like, I think 120 Mercedes 280 SL. They never stop. They never stop. What is this? I think you already know. Lancia Delta Evoluzione 2. So the last version. This is the car that win 5 times the World Rally Championship. Inside, it's insane. My God. This car, like, smell World Championship. If the Countach of before scream 80s, this one scream 90s. Is the most 90s car that I know, and one of the most beautiful ones. And it's so square. My God, I love it. I love it. And this is the best part of the car for me. I always love the fact that there is the small spoiler that you can turn flat or up, depends how much downforce you want on a rear. And we arrive in the heart of the Lancia Delta. You have the 16 valve engine right here. I think the Delta arrived at 220 horsepower more or less, and for the time was not bad at all.
Look the shape here of the sides. It's beautiful.
It's beautiful. I love this car. So yeah, I know it's a cliche because I'm Italian and I love rallies, but I love this car. I love it. Okay, I have no idea what this is, but looks sick. This is called the Cinquone. That means the big five. So as you know, the Fiat 500, five, Cinquone. This car respects in every single detail the name that they give her because it's huge. Watch the size.
What?
The doors here. I have my finger that passed through easily. And even the rear of the body, they make it way wider of what is a normal Fiat 500, even the Abarth. There is the technical details, like that you can see. We have 213 horsepower and there's nothing. Watch the bonnet. Oh, they shape the top of the bonnet to allow the air to go off the engine. And if we go inside, it's crazy. This is made from Romeo Ferraris, that is a constructor. You can design the car as much as you want, so you can change even the stitches on the steering wheel, on the seats. You can change all the things in the car. And the most insane thing is the fact that it is road legal. This car is insane, and thanks the guys of Abarth Club Como that let me check a little bit the puppy. So thank you guys.
Thank you.
Ciao, grazie. Ciao.
Let me know in the comment if you recognize this car. It's from an 80s series, and I can't help saying it's Kit. I say just Kit, and let me know in the comments if you know. And we arrive in the series Italian cars now. We have Lancia Stratos here, another Lancia that won the rally championship in the 72, 73, 76, something like that. The nice part of this car is that have right here on the rear, you have a Ferrari engine. So it was a Lancia powered by a Ferrari engine. And this is f-ing amazing, this car. Rear wheel drive. You see even the exhaust have a different size one to the other. This is one of the car I want to drive one day. Kindly, the owner opened the door and you can see inside there is pretty much nothing, but you have all the things that you need. Like, I think it's speedometer there, you can see the RPM right there, the oil manometer of the oil right here, and all the switches they have to use when they are in the rally stages. So here you have the lights, and the steering wheel is so small, even inside it's super small. Like, I probably will have a hard time fit inside here. And they let me go inside. I will check. I'm with the phone because I was sure with the... Jeez, Luis. Whoa! Okay. It's really tight. It's super tight. I have a problem with the steering wheel. Now, my feet are, as you can see, on the clutch there, on the brake here. And my legs are touching the steering wheel. So yeah, it's pretty tight. It's really, really tight inside. Everything, wait, I change the screen. Everything, I hope the audio is okay. You see the feet are on the right compared to my legs. As you can see, my legs are right here and my feet are right there because everything is more on the right, as you can see. The clutch, it's super hard. And yeah, the big problem is this. Like, I can't move my hands, but it's amazing. My God, even my head, I have one finger and I touch the top of the car. So yeah, it's not made for big dudes. No, not the Stratos. We have a legend car right here. This type of cars have usually a motorcycle engine. You can see Yamaha, see, I think it's the MT-07 engine right here too. And these things have nothing, no electronic, nothing at all. The rear axle of this one is completely welded, so you have all the feeling in the foot and only on that. You can say what you want about the Porsches, that you like the GT4, GT3 RS, the 911. This one, it's a beauty. I don't know why I always love the 944 Turbo. Surely one day, I don't know when, I will buy one of this one. The owner of the 944, Paolo, is going to explain a little bit better the 944, that is amazing. So Paolo, ti lascio la parola.
Ok, buongiorno a tutti. Allora, questo modello di Porsche è il modello originale di 944 Turbo S, prima serie, quindi è Model Year 1988. Ed è stata prodotta in circa 1635 esemplari in totale, di cui 1000 in questo colore che è Silver Rose. La macchina ha 250 cavalli perché ha tutta una serie di optional di serie che non erano presenti sul modello da 220 cavalli, che sono per esempio gli ammortizzatori coni regolabili, un cambio rinforzato, un turbo compressore più grosso, ha l'over boost che permette di avere un leggero incremento di potenza, ha degli interni molto particolari con una stoffa specifica per il modello, ha i cerchioni in lega forgiati, quindi sì, molto alleggeriti rispetto ai classici di 90, infatti questi si chiamano Club Sport.
Ok.
C'ha l'impianto frenante della Porsche 928.
Ok.
E quindi era praticamente la versione stradale della Turbo Cup.
Ok. Quindi la versione, diciamo, più pompata che si può prendere da 944.
Esatto, di quelle non da corsa spesso.
Sì, sì.
Però questa qua è la versione stradale della Turbo Cup.
Motore chiaramente 4 cilindri, 8 valvole. Il turbo compressore c'è, ma è nascosto da sotto, e non si vede mai.
Right under here there is the turbo compressor. Well, I know a lot of you prefer other cars, as I said, like the GT4 right there, but this, it's a diamond. It's amazing.
A lot of people are skipping this, but it's the Maybach. It's the first time in my life I see one in real life, and looks beautiful. We have a V12. The interiors scream richness. Are like, oh, big mommy. Here we are in the part where they are selling the cars. So you have the expo part that was right there. You have the part where you can buy shit, as I said before. And you have this part, and this is the part where everyone are selling their cars. So you can come here, check, like there is a Ford Focus RS right here. You check, you see the engine, it's, my God, it's super clean, and the rims are gorgeous in this one. You can open the door and check everything on the car. There is a 911 right here. As I was saying, you can see there is the number there of the guy, the email and everything. You can call them, or there is an auction they will do the last day, and you can buy the car if you arrive with a good price.
Ferrari Dino 208 GT4, it's identical of the one I tried in the video. So if you didn't see the video, I put you the link right here.
All of these cars, I have no idea what the they are. So if you have the slightest idea what they are, just write the name of the car in the comments, because seriously, I never see. What's this? You ever seen this? First time I seen this in my life. No idea what it is. Okay, from the front griddle, I know that this is a Citroën. No idea what the hell is on reality. An original R5 Maxi Turbo Rally. Yes, just next to the Renault R5 Maxi, there is a 308 GTB that looks amazing. I'm passing through two brands that I think you know pretty well. Okay, let me know if you know them, okay? If my beautiful wife watching this video, this one can be a really nice Christmas gift for me. Come on, it's only 90,000 bucks. Easy. If you want to buy me that on green, it's okay for me either. Huh? I'm not picky. Ferrari. We have the old cars right here. Oh, the 308. Oof. This 308 GTB. Oof. Okay, but not only that, we have the new one right here. So it's pretty cool. And sorry, you're right. We have the racing ones. Which one you prefer? I go inside, start the engine, and get out with the car. Okay. Let me know. And you think that in an event like that, the Ferrari will not bring the new 296 GT3 and the 499 that win the Le Mans? The 499 looks like something alien, like an alien will drive home to work, work to home. Like, okay, an alien arrive on the Earth and say, okay, this is my daily car, and looks like this, because it's something that doesn't make any sense to be real. What the hell is this? If someone know what this is, just let me know in the comments. I have no idea. Never seen this before in my life. I like it. Even if I have no idea what it is, I like it. Okay. I just discovered what is this thing. So this is a Giannarelli. So have a Nissan engine, 6-cylinder, 320 horsepower, 800 kilo. So I think it's pretty powerful, because 320 on 800 kilo, it's a pretty good ratio. As you can see right here, just 30 in the world, and there is only 3 in Europe. It's a pretty cool car. Never seen one before, and I think I'm not going to see this really soon. Okay, I didn't know the guys of Chimera were here. If you don't know them, go check them on Instagram or probably all the platform, they have everything. They make a modern 037. This, okay, next to me is the Chimera 037. So this is a restyling of the old 037 Group B that they make with all the modern things. I didn't expect to see the car here today, and I'm really pleased, because it's one of the most cooler thing I've ever seen in the latest years. I love it. And the cool thing is the fact that they rename each car. So every car, like this, the white one have a name, the yellow one have another name. So that's a pretty cool thing. And here's something really nice. 044S. I thought this wasn't real, honestly, because I saw this in some post, but I thought it was like a concept car. But yeah, it's right here next to me and looks amazing. As you can see, the inspiration of this car is obviously the beautiful Delta S4. I'm lucky to be near to this beast. As you can see, the 044S project of Grassi. So I'm here with the CEO and owner of Grassi, Diego, that is gonna explain us a little bit how this project works. So Diego, ti lascio la parola, we're gonna talk in Italian.
Ciao a tutti. Allora, questo è un nostro nuovo progetto, partiamo da zero, ci siamo ispirati a ciò che è stato il gruppo B e gli anni 80 per quanto riguarda le linee. Infatti non è un vero e proprio resto mod, in quanto appunto non abbiamo nessuna macchina donatrice. Partiamo tutto da zero, telaio, motore, cambio, tutti i componenti che verranno installati su questa vettura sono progettati e realizzati da zero. Siamo partiti con la progettazione dei principali componenti per poi andare a curare ogni minimo dettaglio per la realizzazione del primo esemplare, che vorremmo avere circa nel giro di un paio d'anni. Quindi fine 2025 vogliamo avere la prima vettura funzionante, in modo tale da eseguire test e andare a migliorare eventualmente qualcosa che è migliorabile. Poi da lì partirà la produzione delle 44 vetture.
44 sarà il numero finito?
44, non una in più e non una in meno, perché vogliamo garantire appunto la serietà nei confronti dei nostri acquirenti. Il motore è un 4 cilindri 3000 biturbo, come base di partenza 650 cavalli, verrà fatto ricavato dal pieno, quindi il blocco di alluminio verrà fresato. Quindi abbiamo una certa qualità costruttiva e una rigidezza strutturale interessante. Il posizionato posteriore centrale, quindi subito dietro i sedili dell'abitacolo, per intenderci.
Come la vecchia
S4, diciamo, esatto, la disposizione riprende più o meno quella. Il cambio invece è in mezzo ai sedili, nella parte anteriore, quindi si ottimizza anche la ripartizione dei pesi della vettura. Per l'allestimento base il cambio sarà un 6 marce ad H manuale, e come optional ci sarà un 6 marce sequenziale meccanico, quindi con la classica leva rally style, per intenderci. 4 ruote motrici, 3 differenziali autobloccanti, tutti e 3 a dischi, e vogliamo stare intorno ai 1100 kg di peso.
leggerissima.
Quindi, sì. Dovrebbe muoversi
okay.
abbastanza bene.
Porca. 600 cavalli, 1100 kg.
650 cavalli, 1100 kg. Tutta fibra di carbonio per ciò che riguarda la carrozzeria, gli interni, sedili, plancia, cruscotto, tunnel. Sì. Siamo curiosi anche noi di provarla, non vediamo l'ora.
Ah, assolutamente, quindi l'aspettiamo. In 2025 will arrive because I want to test it. Diego told me that I can. It's not true at all.
Ne parliamo.
He said the first example I can try, but he said that. Huh? It's gonna be a great project. Buona fortuna, sicuramente lo metterete in atto. E non vedo l'ora di vederla girare per le strade.
Teniamo aggiornati, assolutamente.
We keep in touch. So here between a GTR and a Maserati, I think XF1. I'm gonna tell you my thoughts about this day. So, if you like cars, there's so many cars, old ones, new ones. It's a pretty cool place to see cars that you don't have the possibility to see usually. At the same time, it's boring as shit. Come with a friend, like that you can comment, you can discuss the cars, will pass way better the day. And in a lot of cars you can't go inside. I was lucky because I have this thing in front of me, so I could have a little bit more access. You can just watch the cars from the outside. Avoid the junk part, except you need a piece for your old car because it's useless. Hope you like the video. Let me know in the comments. Let me know which car you prefer. If you see your favorite car, maybe I miss it. And as always, see you next time. Bye everyone.